I grew up in Silver Cliff, Wisconsin, which isn't that far from the pig wrestling capital of the world.
The what? The what now?
One year, somebody got their finger bit off and it got lost in the mud. They never found out what happened to that person. Hi, it's me, Trixie Mattel.
And I'm Katya.
And we are two queens who like to watch.
And today, we're watching the brand new Netflix original series.
We are the champions.
Champion.
Do I ever get into winning championships? Yes, I do.
The nichier, the better.
I'm a knitting champion.
Competitive crocheting.
Cup stacking. Do you like that?
I love that.
See, that's a skill you can take right to the bank. This is a show about excellence in fields that maybe you've never even heard of, but we respect excellence in that field anyway.
We sure do. Spoilers galore, so please, if you're hung up on catching the whole season before we talk about it, the door's right over there.
If you want to prove that you're the best hairstylist in the world, there's only one way to do it.
Okay, so this is Bronner Brothers International Hair Show. And in this world, black is excellence, which we stand. But also, it's natural hairstyles partnered with pageantry.
Pushing stuff to the limit.
Mama, this is Drag Race.
We are a staple.
Work.
Black beauty.
Oh! Oh my God. This is amazing.
The choreography, the costumes.
It's fierce. It's like drag, where it's like, let's celebrate the beauty of it, but also kind of make a joke of it.
Like if your normal hairdo is just like a haiku, they go full Homer's The Odyssey.
The Iliad, sis.
The Iliad, yes.
That Legion of Glam is my team.
Okay, so here we have Terrence, who's a competitor.
You ever fantasize about having an entourage?
No, I want the opposite. Trixie, six blocks up there. You can't use this.
Only one model is allowed on stage.
So it's a three-headed woman.
Whoa! Only one model's allowed on stage, and he wants to do a three-headed piece.
Oh, I love triplets.
Terrence's history with the judges is storied.
Transgender people are here. You gave them a platform.
Trailblazer.
This is one of the best things about the beauty industry. Before you can get your foot in the door, your foot and the rest of your body better be entirely accepting of gay and trans people. It'd be all straight people when we do only, like, the Rachel, or, like, you know, a bowl cut. That's the only thing we do. Wow.
Everybody competes and then they do a walk off.
Oh, wait. They're doing it on stage in real time.
Yes.
About smoothness, everything.
Whoa!
The stress factor.
The heat, the sweat coming from you, flood the building.
Lady of the Lake.
Work, bitch.
You create that hairpiece to balance on just one third, you're a boss.
The physics of it, one stumble.
Yeah,
hair ripped.
You're going down.
Girl, they're gonna get that in her head and go, okay, now I just need you to go get on that unicycle and bike out to that stage.
The judges are ready.
This is where you see how black culture created drag culture.
It's like the balls. I mean,
this
is like a ball.
I love this. People in the audience are doing reveals.
You've done a sunglass reveal, haven't you?
Absolutely, I have. I would be screaming at this event. You are, you are.
You would be like escorted out 10 minutes into the competition.
That's because of everything that works. Yes! You'll be at the next one in like a full disguise, trying to get ideas for your looks, trying to take secret pictures. And there's only one way to in the back of the camcorder. Like, is that four Bobby pins? Okay. The Bronner International Hair Show really has everything.
There's probably like years-long beefs and like, you know, rivalries and stuff.
It seems like it has the drama, the fierceness, but it just looks like a joyous thing.
Yeah, like a joyous event.
You and I, they would go to attach these pieces to our real head and find out they have about 45 hairs to work with.
45 is a generous estimate.
They'd be combing my lower back hair up to support it.
Maybe we could tape it to our neck.
Next episode, we're going to the UK for the Brockworth cheese roll, which appears to be a challenge of gravity and dairy.
Two things I'm not really fond of, the UK and cheese.
If the cheese does come over here, protect those kids.
Imagine if you got killed by a cheese wheel.
It is the most dangerous foot race in the world.
And this is no ordinary. Somebody better die. Probably. Oh my God.
Hill is deeper than 45 degrees.
45 degrees is steep.
Now that I think of it, more than 45 degrees is extremely steep.
When things are old and traditional, people will do anything.
Let's do the Brockworth cheese roll.
What? Oh my God. There's a lot of falling.
Oh my God. That's harrowing.
They call it a foot race. I don't see people standing or running.
No, it's like a...
I'm not cold. I'm just scared.
We're here on competition day, and only one cheese roller, as we saw, is going to be the winner. If we were over there on tour and we found out this was going on and it was not that far away, would we do it?
Yes, we would.
No.
I would never do it, though.
I would be at the bottom of the mountain doing a tip spot. Sisters are doing it for themselves. They'd be like, get out my bloody way.
Because it's danger, isn't it? Every sport. You know, you can get smacked in the head by a cricket ball playing cricket, can't you?
I would break my neck. Oh, my God.
It's very dangerous.
Yes, it's insane, actually.
They can't wear helmets. They can't do anything. I mean, it's just bodies. It's not running. Suddenly, frog seems normal. Spice Girls, they were like, thank God. Those British people were doing this, girl.
Separate the boys and the girls.
Wow, somebody's actually on their feet. Oh God. Oh, not that butt.
Long.
Oh God.
Oh my.
Not to mention that little British bowl cut. When I think of like a British person, that's her. The haircut, the stripy shirt, kissing a cheese wheel.
Flailing.
Whoa, that bitch is turning it.
She's walking on sunshine.
Ooh. Please make it. I'm rooting for her. The amount of time they spent not on the ground is shocking.
It's truly wild.
But you know what? If you're going to do it at her age, like a 35-year-old hitting the ground like that, bye. Osteoporosis, bones, disintegrating.
Oh, I'd be dead.
This is psycho.
It's totally psychotic. I can't believe she's like on one piece.
Every bone in my body would snap.
Yeah, dust.
I only have one thing to say. Ding! Dong! All right, in this episode, we're in California, and people are competing in a frog-jumping competition.
Stakes are high, the legs are low.
It's a great day to jump some frogs.
I would have seen this as more of a Florida activity, but let's see what the California
Florida
is doing
as well.
With it.
Must be Northern California.
This is the oldest and biggest frog jump in the world. But have no fear for these dear frogs.
Love the encouragement. Getting down low to the earth, screaming at a frog.
It's almost a person hopping competition as well.
Jump! Get on it!
You gotta want it!
It's now or never!
These frogs don't even know what's going on.
No, it's just business as usual.
Anybody breaks Rosie the Riveter's world record, it's a $5,000 prize. You heard her right.
That's not enough for my frog's bar classes. 21 feet. Hey girl, is that frog wildin' out or is that frog wildin' out?
I am out of here.
She said bye. Who would get into this if you didn't find the frogs kind of cute and charming? And they're kind of cute, right?
Did you ever dissect one in school?
Frog is intense. I mean, the it's laying there like, you know, legs open.
I loved it.
The Gustine team has been jumping for 7 decades.
So Bob has a legacy with frogs. Very passionate about training them, catching them.
Dynasty.
My son, Justin Fasano.
Justin adhered to frog legs.
2017. I mean, literally.
Catching a champion frog is all about preparation and location. The canal.
Sucker canal. Quirky
canal.
I want them to have a gay child, though, who's like, I'm not doing this.
Yeah.
No.
The 91st annual frog jumping jubilee.
Coming for your wigs. Ribbon De Niro.
Go!
The part of it is so funny to me that they're like, go. And the human is like, booga, booga, booga.
I know. It's so extra.
Booga, booga, booga.
Writhing around on the ground screaming.
For Riley Kitchell, there's one simple path to victory.
Go, kid.
Become one with the frog.
He's fine. Ooh, blowing. Nice.
Absorbed
nice.
In the moment. I'm more impressed with his jump. Very nice.
The only thing standing between him and another Calaveras team trophy is this 12-year-old.
We have Logan Bush.
One.
Kitchell is pissed.
That 12-year-old.
You done good, kid.
It is very California to be like, stop eating the frogs. Give them a place in society.
Give them an outlet.
They gotta jump. I would go to this.
I would too. I would get satanic. I would just like,
you'd be the first person to try to enter the competition as a frog. Okay, screen wipe. We're in South Carolina, and this is the chili eating competition. Chili peppers.
I love crying from eating.
Sweating.
Like hyperventilating.
I can take a lot of heat, both on the internet and at a Mexican restaurant.
I just get stressed out about the delayed reaction.
Oh yeah, sometimes the pepper isn't hot first, and then like a minute and a half in, you're like, oh my god.
Just chewing on peppers by themselves.
Girl, the these people are taking the next day. It's over.
Oh, I'm sure.
Ripping skin, the toilet stained red, like it's over. So this is the first competition, and we have a trans woman competing, which I love. As a trans woman in America, she's like, we only have to eat peppers.
Absolutely.
Smokin' Ed became a star of the industry and a cult hero when he set the Guinness World Record for the hottest pepper ever tested.
What do? I grow the hottest peppers in the world, bitch. That is so cool.
The Reaper? 5,000 times hotter, breaking 1.641.
These people are psychotic.
What would happen if you rubbed it in your eyes?
I mean, it could knock you out.
I feel like if you snipped it, you'd probably razor blades.
White people.
White people.
White people.
White people.
This show should just be like called White People Doing People
Bit. Yeah.
How do you not puke? I mean, come on.
I watch these other contests. The peppers they use just aren't hot.
Walks into other chili competitions and is like, champions. All right, how would y'all grow the f*** up? Not impressed. Like, oh, did you want some salt with that? Oh.
Yeah.
Never done.
Jumping out of a plane with 10 Reaper peppers in his mouth.
What the f***?
What? This guy wants to die.
I'm transgender.
Meryl Streep.
All of that discrimination or anger gets pushed in to eating these chilies, and that's what gets me through.
You better work.
This is the easiest thing I'll do all week.
She's like, the real problem is, are you gonna let me use the bathroom?
Ability. She retired out of boredom. Competition so easy.
Well, I guess I'll quit now.
It's cool.
Quit out of boredom.
So now we're going to the pepper eating competition. Wait, pucker butt pepper competition. Pucker butt.
She's got those bad English teeth.
She's got those bad English teeth. She can't chew fast enough.
He really just said that to the camera.
I've got monkey chompers.
That girl is Nancy from The Craft.
Yeah.
Oh, these poor people. Oh, the tears.
When does it stop burning? That's what I want to know.
I love that this is about championing the human spirit. Pick something less painful, Mary. Oh my gosh. Oof.
It's a hobby. Don't torture yourself. Their name will end up on a check
for $1,000.
A $1,000 to mangle your inside.
Get a part-time job at the Nordstrom's. That neither of them are bottoming tonight. Let me just say that.
Not this month.
Girl, I dare you to try to f*** me the day I have this chili eating competition. Your d*** will disintegrate.
Literally sizzle right off the body.
I mean, my boyfriend, he's like, the ketchup is spicy. I am gonna pepper spray him. I'm gonna try to break him out of it. This series is all very drag related because drag is stupid. But there is sort of like, if we're gonna do something dumb, let's try to do it well. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, absolutely.
This is very the energy of this. All right, so we are entering the world of dog dancing.
Well, what did they win? $300? Oh my god.
Oh my god.
They do the same thing with bears.
Bear dancing? Russia is wild. That is amazing.
That is so cute.
My hair is very beautiful. People tell to me.
My dog dance really nice.
I love that hair. Like the stereotype of like Russian woman, like blonde hair at the expense of murdered, damaged texture.
I will process this hair no matter what the cost.
Paulina knows that Irina can dance, but will Irina dance too hard?
Girl, diva, you better work it.
You gotta stay fierce and dance with that dog.
I've seen homosexuals in West Hollywood walking their dogs in a similar way. I don't think she's dancing that hard. I thought she was gonna be like...
I thought she was gonna be pummeling the ground.
I thought she was gonna be like tongue out, eyes rolled back, like, be like, this is nothing. She's just doing this.
Yeah.
Will she take the title?
She walks by that other girl and just goes, eat
you ugly sick of
break a leg, bitch.
She's very pleased.
She did good. In a way, drag is dog dancing.
Except we are the dogs.
I've been to Hamburger Mary's on the weekend. In 98 degree weather, watching a grown man in a wig lip sync in the sunlight. It is dog dancing, okay?
I could get into dog dancing. Dog dance choreographer.
That'd be love that for you.
Dog dance choreographer
to the stars.
To the stars.
I would think that dogs are very reliable as dance partners.
I just hope it doesn't turn sexual.
This show has everything. Russian people, dog dancing, tracksuits, bullfrogs, running down a hill, dairy, cheese, British people, difficult teeth, hair competitions, wigs, balls, bang pieces,
rule breaking, trailblazing, risk taking.
And it has greatness in many forms, which is always worth celebrating.
So check out We Are the Champions on Netflix.com.